your soul with it. What's going on, everybody? The Island Ricks coming to you live with yet another video. If you're new to the channel, please be sure to click that subscribe button. So I want to talk to y'all about LeBron James and the truth on why he wants to join the Los Angeles Lakers. I'm going to give you guys my opinion, you know, and my theory on why I think he will sign with the Lakers in the 2018 free agency. To me, the writings are on the wall. You know, I look into clues like, you know, I could be wrong, like, everybody that, you know, could be wrong, you know, people be like, oh, well, he takes a picture. If you take a picture in front of the LAX sign or the Hollywood sign, then, oh, now he wants to join the Lakers. You guys are always jumping the gun, blah, 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 you know. So I hear that all the time. You know, I even heard it when LeBron James went to Miami. I always said that LeBron James was going to go back to Cleveland. He was going to go back to Cleveland. Everybody called me crazy. They called me insane. They say, oh, that's stupid. Why? He's not going back to Cleveland. He's not going back to Cleveland. He's not going to do this. He's not going to do that. He ended up going back to Cleveland. I proved everybody wrong. They said that Kevin Durant wasn't going to join the Warriors. They said I was crazy and delusional for saying that. Then Kevin Durant ended up joining the Warriors. You know, LeBron James does not stick around for a rebuild. Like, just look at his career and actually analyze it and see if he ever stuck around for a rebuild. He's never stuck around for one. So, you know, he even had Andrew Wiggins traded away. You know, he said he wanted, I think it was Sebastian Napier. I don't know if, you know, he would have panned out to be great. But, you know, LeBron wanted the Miami Heat to draft him. You know, and when they did, you know, when they was, I think they did draft him and he was gone. You know, LeBron James left. So he went back to, you know, the Cleveland Cavaliers. He said he was going to win a championship for them. You know, LeBron James really prides himself on his legacy. You know, you always hear him talk about his legacy. Charles Barkley said something about him. Oh, you're not going to disrespect my legacy. He really cares about his legacy. You know, I think that in LeBron James' mind, you know, it's all about chasing Michael Jordan and finding ways, you know, of trying to be in the conversation and, you know, just people debating who is better, LeBron James or Michael Jordan. You know, so when the history books could be written, I believe in LeBron James' mind, it would be, oh, well, did Michael Jordan ever beat a, you know, 73 or 9 team? Did Michael Jordan go to, you know, 3 different teams and turn them into, you know, NBA champions? You know, so it's going to be that comparison, you know. And if LeBron James could, it would be, you know, phenomenal for his, you know, just think about his career. Just to imagine if he's able to defeat the Golden State Warriors. Let's say he go to the Lakers and he team up with, because there's rumors that he wants to team up with, you know, Russell Westbrook, you know, and it would be a great story if Russell Westbrook is going at, you know, Kevin Durant in the Western Conference Finals. You know, I don't know how they can make it happen. The Lakers will have to get rid of some young pieces and make a lot of moves in order for it to happen. But if LeBron James wants to play with Russell Westbrook, because that's the rumors, you know, LeBron James wants to team up with Russell Westbrook. Paul George said he's going to join the Lakers. So if those guys are there, you know, before LeBron James get there, then that will increase his decision to go join there. Because if you actually look at the Cavaliers situation that they're in now, you know, it's just insurance. Reports came out that Isaiah Thomas will be out for at least 3 or 4 months. And it was mainly for, to me, LeBron is once LeBron James leave, they want to make sure they have some insurance. So when he's gone, they could have a first round pick. They could have a second round pick. They don't care about Isaiah Thomas because Isaiah Thomas, they're not going to pay him anyway. They're not going to give him, you know, the money. And they talk about Derrick Rose. There's Derrick Rose that, come on now, like, LeBron James wants superstars. Look, Derrick Rose is not a superstar. He don't have no superstars on that team, you know. And I don't believe that they're going to beat the Boston Celtics. Possibly they can, but I don't think so. I think it's just deja vu for LeBron. I think in his mind, all he already has going to the Lakers in his mind, just like when he left Cleveland the first time, he had gone to Miami in his mind. You know, I think that's why he didn't care, you know, if he lost against the Boston Celtics, because he already had in his mind he was going to the Miami Heat. And, you know, once he was finished with the Miami Heat, he already had in his mind that he was going to give up and just go play for the Cleveland Cavaliers again, go back home. And now I believe in his mind, he feel like he's going to go to the Lakers, team up with Paul George, you know, Russell Westbrook and Lonzo Ball. You know, I'm not saying that Russell Westbrook going to come, but we know for sure that Paul George is coming and he's going to team up with Lonzo Ball. And they could all defeat the Warriors And I think they're going to create a rivalry between the Boston Celtics and the Los Angeles Lakers once again. And they're going to just feed off that story between LeBron James going against Kyrie Irving and the Boston Celtics. You know, it wouldn't make sense for LeBron James to stay in the Eastern Conference and keep going to the finals every year and keep losing and messing up his finals record. You're not going to beat the Warriors or none of those teams in the West. So you might as well come to the West. And the only team that you really have to worry about is the Warriors. And if you have a stacked up team, you could beat that team. You could beat the Warriors, go to the finals, and it'd be like a cakewalk because you would beat the teams. They'll be so easy. You know, you got LA, you got sunny weather, you got the film industry. You know, everything is at LeBron James' disposal, and I'm pretty sure that he wants to be in Los Angeles. He has his own TV show. You know, he wants to own his own team. Like, everything that he wants is in Los Angeles. And I think that by 2018, that's where LeBron James will sign with the Lakers. You know, the similar playing styles with Lonzo Ball and Magic Johnson. You know, he could learn a lot from Magic in terms of like ownership and certain things. But anyway, y'all let me know what y'all think in that comment box. Like, share, subscribe. I'm out.
Look. Straight from the soul with it.